Let's examine and rank all the Breaking Bad characters introduced in Season 3 of Better Call Saul. If you haven't already, be sure to check out the Season 1 and 2 videos linked now. We didn't get Gus in the Season 2 finale, just a note he left behind. Then Mike took a long time to track this down to Gus. It wasn't until the second episode of Season 3 that we finally get what we've been waiting for. After over 5 minutes with zero dialogue while Mike investigates, we get our first clue. This sign pole that fans might recognize. Followed by glimpses of the windows that might make people say, "Hey, is that..." Get this dramatic reveal to cap off an unbelievable 7 minutes and 38 seconds with no speaking. Unlike other reveals, this one has got to seem a bit weird to viewers who aren't familiar with Breaking Bad. But still no Gus.
Hello?
Oh, hey, come on in.
Hi, I'm Francesca Liddy.
And then, out of nowhere, it's Francesca. Thanks to Jimmy, she gets hired to help both Jimmy and Kim, and it's nice to see her before she turns into the hardened secretary in Breaking Bad.
Hey, look, there's gotta be at least $1,700 there, okay? That'll more than cover the cost of the doornail. I apologize profusely, please. The phone number.
Door like this? It's gonna cost way more than $1,700.
What? For a plate of glass? No.
Oh, yeah. I bet it does. I bet you it winds up costing $20,000.
Are you insane? Who the hell is going to charge $20,000 for a plate glass door? There's no reputable vendor would.
Now I'm thinking 25.
I'll be right back.
Francesca is one of the rare Breaking Bad characters that we get to know a lot better in Better Call Saul. I think she deserves a B. Later, we finally get our first glimpse of you-know-who. And you can cut the tension with a knife as he gets gradually closer. And after 6 minutes and 37 seconds of no real dialogue...
Can I help you?
My watch clasp is loose. It falls. I tried to reach it.
I'm sorry. Allow me.
Yeah, they say a nice watch band is as important as the watch. That's what I get for cheaping out.
We'll find it for you.
You can't spell Gus without S. But for Better Call Saul, I have to give him only an A. He's absolutely an S in Breaking Bad, but gets outshined here. Shortly after this reveal, we get introduced to some of his henchmen. That was pretty cool.
All his bullshit aside, it's called a cook. Because everything comes down to following a recipe. Simple, complicated, it doesn't matter. Steps never change. And I know every step.
Oh, is that what you want? This short order cook? You're not flipping hamburgers here, pal. What happens when you get a bad barrel of precursor? How would you even know it? And what happens in summer when the humidity rises and your product goes cloudy?
This does not end well for Victor. Victor just gets a D.
It's not in my interest for Hector Salamanca to die at this time.
Who is he to you?
An associate of an associate.
How very specific.
Who is he to you?
We don't see Tyrus up close until 3 episodes later.
All the same weight?
Within a quarter gram.
Do you have a scale?
Take your pick.
I've got to admit, I was confused at first, as the supposedly younger Tyrus looks like his own dad. Although by season 6 of Better Call Saul, Tyrus starts looking younger and thinner, so I guess it checks out. I think it's fair to give Tyrus a D.
Me?
Gus's personal doctor is back. It is really weird that his last name is Goodman.
I need a package. Yay big.
And what's that in grams?
Uh-huh. This big.
4 for 4! Help! Oh, assistance! This man needs help!
This man pays my salary.
Barry gets a D for always being so rude to Mike. Don Eladio's reveal is pretty straightforward.
Whoa, sabrosito. Y está guiñando. Mieres, ¿qué me dices? ¿Se parece a mí?
Because this is a flashback, Eladio's reverse aging is a bit striking. I'll give Don Eladio a C.
Hey. Bolsa.
In the same flashback, we get Juan Bolsa, part of the cartel and mediator between Salamanca's and Gus.
Chico de la chingada.
Eladio, qué gusto verlo, eh? Está bien. Hector.
Bolsa.
Este Heisenberg, Walter White, era uno de los proveedores locales de Tuco, hasta que traicionó Tuco. Ya sabes, la sangre se paga con sangre. Los primos de Tuco tienen derecho a vengarse. La familia Salamanca, el cartel, todos están unidos en este asunto.
I'm giving him a low D, in part because it feels like there was so much potential to make him a more interesting character.
I need highly skilled, high-end, discreet, real pro.
You gotta fit him in a tight space?
I don't think so.
I got just the guy then.
Excuse me.
Sorry, it's yours.
Huel is a fan favorite from Breaking Bad.
Can I help you?
Yeah. Thanks.
What were you just kidding? What's this about?
I'll tell you what this is about, Mr. Beneke. This is about you and me doing our best to keep Huel happy.
Huel? Who's Huel?
This is Huel. Huel, you happy?
Reasonably.
Until seeing them side by side, I didn't realize how much Huel has changed between the two shows. For Better Call Saul, Huel gets a B.
It could work.
Okay, then.
It's interesting to see Lydia before she becomes the nervous wreck we know from Breaking Bad.
Sorry, we don't have chamomile tea.
Then some sort of bergamot, provided it's not Earl Grey, and I'd like soy milk instead of dairy.
We don't have soy milk or any sort of bergamot.
I might put her as high as an A in Breaking Bad, but for Better Call Saul, I'm going to say C. That's it for season 3. Did you already know these characters were from Breaking Bad? Do you agree or disagree with my rankings? Let me know.